Lina's Town Rises Again, inspired by a true story, by Chat Garrido Ocampo. Lina, a clever 7-year-old girl, lives in the small and beautiful town of Lambayong in southern Philippines. Lambayong is a farming community where the town folks get everything from farming. They get their food from whatever they harvest, and they sell what is left to earn money for their other needs. However, many times, the harvest was not enough to meet even their basic needs. There were times when the town folks were not able to eat every mealtime.
Nanay, why do we not have enough to eat when Tatay works so hard every day in the field so that we will have enough food?
Lina thoughtfully said. I see him leave so early in the morning to work in the farm. This is not good, Nanay, and this cannot happen all the time. Lina's Nanay agrees, but can only give a sigh. Indeed, if only there was more food even just for the young ones like Lina. It is not good for young children to go hungry, but the weather has not been good, and so their harvest was little. One day, a very strong typhoon came. The strong winds angrily beat against the trees and destroyed all standing crops. It rained so hard for days. The town folks were forced to leave their houses, lest they would drown as the water continued to rise. When it was finally over, Lina's town was completely underwater. Lambayong literally became water world. Lina's Nanay cried and cried. What will they do? Where will they go? Nanay looked at Lina and her siblings. They were all wet and shivering. First, there was not enough food. Now, they even have to leave home. The municipal government opened the public school for the town folks to stay until the water subsided. Donations of food and clothing also came from neighboring towns. Lina's family and all the residents of Lambayong were thankful that they were getting some help. After a few days, the water went down. Lina's family left the public school to go back home. But alas, there was no home to go back to. Their house, including their crops and farm animals, were all gone. Worse, the typhoon also destroyed the irrigation canal, which was their farm's sole source of water. With no house and no source of income, what will happen to them now? Lina's grandparents let them stay in their home until they have enough money to rebuild their own home.
Nanay, my slippers now have many holes. You think we can buy a new pair soon?
Lina asked her Nanay one day.
Anak, we have no harvest to sell, and we need to save for the coming months, Nanay replied.
I'm sorry, but I cannot buy you a new pair of slippers yet. Lina's parents started to take odd jobs here and there as debts started to pile up. There was always little food and not much money to buy even the most basic necessities. However, Lina's family did not lose hope. They never forgot to pray every night for things to change for the better. Soon after, their persistent prayers were answered. One afternoon, Lina's uncle and aunt who lived in another town came to visit. They came with pasalubong for Lina and her siblings and even gave Nanay some cash.
We had a very good harvest this season, said Lina's aunt.
Lina's uncle shared that a salesman talked to them about a new type of corn. They became so curious that they attended a seminar where they found out that the new corn was a biotech corn called DeKalb. Encouraged by what they learned about DeKalb, Lina's aunt and uncle decided to plant the corn in their field, and when harvest time came, they had such an excellent harvest.
We never had this kind of harvest in the past. It was really a blessing, Lina's aunt exclaimed.
They encouraged Lina's parents to also plant DeKalb corn so they could have a better life. Lina's tatay said he had no money to buy seeds. Besides, he was already thinking of finding work in the city rather than do farming and then harvesting nothing afterwards. Lina's uncle encouraged Lina's tatay not to give up on farming and immediately lent him money to buy seeds. Lina's uncle believed that Lina's parents could easily pay back the loan because he expected them to have a very good harvest. Lina's uncle said biotech corn would grow so well because it was resistant to corn borer, cutworm, and earworm, which were causing huge problems for farmers in Lina's town. If you plant DeKalb corn, you would no longer have these problems and for sure you would have a good harvest, Lina's uncle excitedly assured them. And so Lina's parents planted biotech corn in their 4-hectare farmland. When harvest time came, they had a lot of good corn, so they were able to raise enough money to pay all their debts.
Lena's family also had more money now to buy food. Our family will not go hungry anymore, Lena, Nanai happily said. During the next planting season, Lena's parents were so encouraged that they even rented more land to be able to plant more biotech corn. They wanted to earn more and be able to rebuild their house. Harvest time came again, and Lena's parents had a lot of good corn to sell. Soon after, Lena's parents started building their new house, which was bigger, more beautiful, and made of stronger materials. Soon after, their neighbors noticed that Lena's family has prospered. They also asked what their secret was because they, too, wanted to improve their lives. Lena's parents shared that they planted biotech corn, which gave them a good harvest. With more corn to sell, they are now earning more money for their needs. During the next planting season, Lena's neighbors also planted biotech corn. When harvest time came, they all had a good harvest. Everyone was so happy. Lena's neighbors now have more money for their needs, and they have started rebuilding their homes. Soon after, the whole town of Lambayong started planting biotech corn. Planting and harvesting seasons came and went, and the town folks consistently had a good harvest of corn. Lambayong became a prosperous town. All families built nice houses, and no one was ever hungry again. The town folks were so grateful for their blessings that they were always willing to share their secret to having an abundant life. Plant DeKalb corn and you will have a good harvest, they would tell other farmers whenever they had a chance. The town folks share this good news with a sincere hope that all other farming families will no longer go hungry and start to lead prosperous and happy lives. The end.